fighting out of Coupe Alto, Puerto Rico. Please welcome the undefeated challenger, Felix Tito Trinidad.
No quitting blocker, though. He's throwing. He knows he's in trouble. He knows it's almost over, and he is trying.
Flippity left, and down goes blocker.
Holding on.
And Trinidad's such a good finisher. He won't let Turner off the hook. That's it.
Gabriel Garcia knocking him down four times in the first round.
He composed now and stalking Lucian.
Ooh. Oh, digging. There it is. The left final seconds of the 10.
When he does, he seems to take it. Oh,
there he goes. Carr down to the canvas. Now he goes up and finish. Down he goes again. Trinidad goes right back in. Combination of that. Blood spurting.
Fight
and Gonzalez
over.
Steps in. It's all over.
Patient. Bobby, that punch is getting closer and closer.
Before Pendleton went down.
Trouble. You can't go toe-to-toe. You cannot exchange for Trinidad. Straight right.
Oh, look out. He's ready to go.
Clinical effort by Felix Trinidad. And he is racking up the damage against Larry Barnes.
I've been a champion for 6 years, but it's time for the big purses now, and it's time for the big fights that years ago I never got. Not because of me, but because of the promoters. But it's 1999, and it'll be a great year for me.
26-year-old welterweight champion Felix Trinidad is in his 10th year of professional boxing. But because he's never received the kind of exposure or prize money he feels he deserves, he's fought only 3 times in the last 28 months and remains relatively little known.
It's bothersome, yes. Inactivity can hurt a boxer's career. He's not earning money. He's not seen. He's not maintaining his level of visibility. But we got a good contract for him now. He's being paid what he's worth on the market.
Ya está todo bien, gracias a Dios.
On 2 occasions, I've had 7 and 8 months of inactivity. This time, I've gone 9 months without a fight. But now we're done with this whole thing with Don King, the conflicts in court in New York and in Puerto Rico. It's all been resolved.
Unhappy to have been an underpaid, undercard fighter throughout his career, Trinidad ended his feud with promoter Don King when King rewarded Felix with a multi-year, multi-million dollar contract. It will finally shift the focus from the courtrooms to the boxing ring.
At one time, you could say that Don King didn't value my career enough. I wasn't paid per fight what I'm worth. But now I'll earn big money in my next fight. What we want to do is just boxing, boxing, boxing. Get some big fights and show those who may have any doubts that there is no one better than me.
The timing couldn't be any better for Trinidad. In the competitive, star-studded 147-pound division, a win over Whitaker could open doors for a possible showdown with Oscar De La Hoya after De La Hoya's split decision victory over Ike Quarte last week.
His time has come. I've been saying that for a long time. Along with the financial compensation, he's got to get the big fights. The promoters know that to pay him, they've got to get fighters who will attract the public. And Tito wants to fight those boxers who are at his level, too.
Now appearing in his first big fight, since he decisioned Hector Camacho and knocked out Yuri Boycampos and Oba Carr 5 years ago, Trinidad is confident a victory over Whitaker will bring him the recognition that has eluded him for so long.
I think that after this fight with Whitaker, when I win, I'm sure the public and everyone else will see that I am the best pound for pound. After that fight, there will be no doubt that I'm number one.
Further complicating Trinidad's obscurity problem is the fact he still lives in his native Puerto Rico.
I've lived here all my life. My family is here, my people. I like it here. I like the atmosphere. And no matter where I go, everyone, Puerto Ricans, Americans, everyone says hello.
So Felix Trinidad's moment to make a mark in contemporary welterweight history has finally arrived. There should be no more excuses about problems with promoters and insufficient prize money. He has his big money contract now, and seeks to gain respect to go along with it.
Felix Trinidad is on a mission. The man from Coupe, Puerto Rico, says his matchup against Oscar De La Hoya is a chance to repay the Golden Boy for some unsavory comments he made regarding Trinidad's worth.
He said I wasn't worth $10 million.
I believe that's devaluating my worth, and it's insulting. How can he say I'm not worth $10 million? I'm worth that and more. That's why on September 18th, he'll pay dearly for all those comments he made about me. I'll gladly pay him back when we step into the ring.
Trinidad is well aware of what's at stake. He's not awed at the task that lies ahead for him, but rather quite confident in what the outcome will be.
I've had important fights before, but this fight is very important. And when it's all over, and they raise my hand as the winner and champion of the IBF, and the champion of the WBC, then the whole world will take notice and recognize that there is no doubt I am the best.
And Trinidad is just as candid when he speaks about De La Hoya's debut in the welterweight division, a victory against Pernell Whitaker.
I believe Whitaker won that fight, and a lot of people have said the same thing, that Oscar does not win that fight. However, the judges saw him as the winner. That's fine. It's been 2 years that he's been champion, but that will come to an end on September 18th.
However, he's a bit humble when it comes to discussing his skills in the ring. Then again, if you're undefeated in 35 fights and you have reigned as champion for more than 5 years, your actions speak louder than words.
Whenever my friends, my family go with me to the gym and they watch me train, they always have a new phrase for me. And this one is, and a new WBC and IBF champion. It means a lot to me that I will be the champion of the WBC. I have no doubt about being the champ and beating Oscar.
And I'll keep searching for different ideas. And we'll have much more inside the ring. The more, the better. Because I'm going to beat De La Hoya. I'm sure of that.
I really don't like to predict which round, but I believe some fans and several people have said that De La Hoya will go down in the fourth round.
But he can go down in any round. It's rounds. He knows a lot about boxing. I don't believe it will go more than 6 rounds. Maybe in the 8th. To be honest, I don't know if I have great boxing skills. I'll punch, fight offensively, or defensively. Whatever it takes. If my dad says to box him, then I'll go out there and I'll box him. And if I have to go out there and fight him, then I'll go out there and fight him. And I swear to you that I'm going to.
I'm telling to you, Oscar.
September 18,
I'm going to win.
Y voy a ganar por knockout.
I'm going to beat you by knockout.
Let's do it. Let's do it. This is it. This is what I've been waiting for.
A year and a half ago, welterweight champion Felix Tito Trinidad walked into Madison Square Garden to finally bring his career out of the shadows. Despite 14 previous title defenses, it wasn't until February 1999 that Trinidad was first face-to-face with a marquee opponent. That's when Felix took on Olympic gold medalist and longtime pound-for-pound king, Pernell Whitaker.
That was a difficult fight because of Pernell Whitaker's style. He does a lot of bending and moving around. That's one of his hallmarks.
He's been having so much trouble with Whitaker, and yet he's maintained his poise.
Down goes Whitaker on a straight right hand.
I did learn something, to take things more calmly, not to get frustrated in the ring. I like to go for the knockout, but I can't win by decision. The most important thing is not to make any rash decisions.
And Olympic gold medalist into the ring, Oscar De La Hoya. The long-anticipated super fight to superstardom was bigger than just unifying the welterweight division. And the pressure of this career-defining moment made Trinidad uneasy.
the most anticipated non-heavyweight showdown of this decade.
If you're nervous, it doesn't mean you're afraid. You're nervous because you don't want to disappoint the fans. You want to do well with all the attention you're getting.
The lessons of patience Trinidad had learned from the Whitaker bout backfired here, and Oscar took advantage.
Outclass is too big a word for what's happening here, but it's verging on that.
Oscar de la Hoya always had his hands in front. My fight against him was harder because he moves around a lot. I was chasing him, and it was difficult because my hand almost couldn't reach.
But then, De La Hoya sat on his lead, and Trinidad desperately played catch-up.
He's got to win round 12 to at least pull out a draw.
Felix eked out an upset win, a disputed decision, while the lackluster fight frustrated all its massive expectations.
Some people have said that maybe it wasn't the fight of the millennium, because it wasn't a good fight, but I don't agree. Maybe Oscar thinks that, but I was there to fight.
With the victory, Tito was king of the welterweights, and a bigger hero than ever in Puerto Rico. When terms for a rematch with De La Hoya collapsed, Trinidad targeted yet another American Olympic gold medalist.
Once he beat De La Hoya, we got the opportunity to go up in weight. The door was opened. That was David Reed. A lot of people thought this fight would stop Tito.
Adjusting to an added 7 pounds, combined with another slow start to create a near disaster.
He was lucky. He hit me and I went down. People said I was a little slow in the early rounds. I didn't see it that way. I tried to keep my rhythm. He landed a good hit, but it cost him in the end.
For the second fight in a row, Trinidad needed a gutty second half comeback to win. The new title further enhanced the Latino hero's delayed star status.
I've had 37 fights, undefeated, 30 knockouts. I've beaten 3 gold medalists. I have fought against 6 mandatory number one challengers during my career. I've beaten them all. Tito can be the best pound-for-pound fighter in the world. Pernell Whitaker, Oscar de la Hoya, David Reed, they were great boxers. Beating them makes me very proud, for myself and also for Puerto Rico. When my career is done, it will be there, recorded in history.
Tito Trinidad's road to glory opened up much later than he had planned. But by tarnishing 3 gold medalists in 13 months, he has carved out a spot on center stage and now looks to state his case as best pound for pound.
Felix Trinidad, a boxing superstar who uses every outing to make his case as the sport's best pound for pound boxer, taking on Fernando Vargas, an angry boxer, as we've said, who sees this as an opportunity to become a megastar. Felix Trinidad, Fernando Vargas, the two best junior middleweights in the world in a fight of the year showdown. The Puerto Rican champion is the veteran, unbeaten in 16 title appearances.
He's never faced a fighter with Trinidad's punching power before.
2 years ago, Felix Trinidad rose to glory.
I'm the best junior middleweight in the world, best pound for pound. I want the world to know that. I will prove that.
The Mexican-American's potential rocketed the night he became the youngest 154-pound champion.
Vargas, at 21 years old, is a world champion.
In his brief career, Fernando Vargas has emerged as one of the game's best new title holders.
17 knockouts in a row, a ferocious Fernando Vargas.
This spring, the young champion became a great champion against dangerous Ike Corte.
Fernando Vargas believes he has Corte. Ready to go.
Tonight, the stakes are higher as the rising star risks his own fame in this mega fight showdown.
I just don't want to wake up out of this dream. You know, I'm 22 years of age and I'm pretty much on top of the world, and after this fight, I will be on top.
Two undefeated champions in the sport's most talented division take a step closer to be crowned one of the best in boxing.
It's going to work.
Then you got to back it up, though.
Big left hook by Trinidad, and Vargas is stunned. Vargas is stunned and down.
And you know how stunned he is? Because he didn't take the full count. He got up too quickly.
That's sensational left hook.
Trinidad can't go to the well. He's not playing around now.
second knockdown for Trinidad. He's the one who said it would be a quick, dominant knockout performance. This is not what any expert expected.
In. Felix Tito Trinidad. Jim, there's no question. And in the last four rounds, Tito Trinidad is one of these three.
Down goes Vargas on a big left hook. And up he gets in 2 seconds. And now it's abundantly clear. Fernando Vargas must score a knockout or he's lost this fight. Down goes Fernando again.
He's seriously hurt. He doesn't have his wits about him. He is reacting simply from instinct and courage.
He's out of it. He can't see Trinidad. He's about to get knocked out. Barring a miracle here, it's going to be a closing knockout for Tito. Fernando trying to survive. Fires a couple of punches. And holds on like a skilled veteran.
He's a veteran.
And that'll do it. The third right hand, the third knockdown of the round. A huge victory for Tito Trinidad.
A historic accomplishment in boxing. How many people have done it?
Well, he's trying to join some of the greats of boxing. All of these fighters outstanding in their times. Mickey Walker in the 20s. Duran and Basilio briefly held on to the titles.
This middleweight unification series looks to restore the division to its rightful place of glory in boxing.
The middleweight world championship series is proving itself to be a format that rekindles the spirit of champions. The winner of this tournament will bear the distinction of beating the best and being the best in the 160-pound division. The first bout of the series pitted Bernard Hopkins versus Keith Holmes. The executioner's relentless body attack to Holmes allowed him to outlast the WBC champion.
It's a Bernard Hopkins kind of a fight.
Now with two titles in hand, Bernard Hopkins awaits the winner of tonight's clash. On deck, Felix Trinidad, with 39 wins, 32 by knockout, and no losses, is one of the best fighters of this generation. However, he is still unproven as a middleweight.
What a champion!
For the talented Trinidad. His opponent, William Joppy, with 32 wins of his own, including 24 knockouts. The two-time WBA title holder has the resolve to triumph and advance against his most dangerous opponent ever. After recovering from a near-fatal car accident in 1999, Joppy resumed his career with the conviction to prove that he is the best 160-pounder in the world.
Three middleweights you would face, Holmes, Joppy, or Hopkins. You chose Joppy. Why?
Bueno, pensamos que... que era el mejor campeón de los tres campeones, el boxeador que más activo ha estado y es un peleador también de Don King y creo que va a ser una gran oportunidad y le voy a ganar al mejor el mediano.
Tito, it's the second time that you've moved up in weight in 20 months. Obviously, as you move up, the opponents hit a little bit harder. Are you at all concerned about the power of Joppy tonight?
Bueno, es posible que voy a pegar más fuerte, pero también yo voy a pegar más fuerte y ustedes verán hoy de qué soy capaz.
All right, well, good luck tonight.
The devil will be in the details of this fight. A terrific and perhaps telling first round.
Joppy goes down on a barrage of left hooks. Six, seven, eight. So just as he floored Vargas in the first round, so too did Trinidad floor Joppy in round one. And Joppy wrestles his way to the bell.
Joppy still hasn't sat down. Trinidad with two hard right hands now. Stopping Joppy in his tracks. Big left hook. Second knockdown of the fight. Joppy tremendously hurt by this fight.
Six, seven.
Joppy went down to the body.
Two, three, four.
That'll do it.
Five, six.
I don't think Bertanti's going to let William Joppy continue. Felix Trinidad with a sensational knockout. Sensational performance by the greatest finisher in the sport. Tito Trinidad may be the deadliest puncher in these divisions since Ray Robinson.
the winner by way of technical knockout, and he is the new WBA middleweight champion of the world, El Gran Campeón Puerto Ricano, Felix Tito Trinidad.
So Trinidad's 40th victory, the 33rd by knockout, his 20th win in a championship fight. Now half the fights in his career have been title fights. An incredible journey to him.
He can be mentioned now right along with all of the previous middleweight greats. He's done it. He showed me. He made a believer.
Number 29, 2001. What was expected to be Felix Trinidad's coronation as undisputed king of the middleweight division evolved into an entirely different story with an unexpected ending.
Hard right hand by Hopkins. Biggest blow of the fight.
I don't believe what I'm seeing.
Hopkins imposing his will and his skill on the man who is tonight the lesser fighter.
Now just over 7 months removed from the most difficult night of his boxing career, Trinidad is ready to step back into the ring.
I want to show to the people that there is still a lot of Tito Trinidad that I have to offer to the public.
And just how will Tito return to his winning ways? Along with his father and trainer, Felix Trinidad Sr., he has resisted the notion of drastic change. Unlike other fighters who have faced similar circumstances in recent years.
I see no reason to change if I've had positive results in my training regimen in the past.
He's going to come in and do what he does, which is look to knock you out.
But the man who has guided Tito's career from the start admits some minor adjustments were necessary.
Now we have different sparring partners. These are boxers who are younger, a little bit lighter in weight, and more mobile. Movement was an important factor because against Hopkins, Tito was an easy target.
Trinidad Sr. made changes outside the ring as well, relocating training camp to the Pedrin Soria Gymnasium.
So that when we're working, we're not distracted and we're all concentrated on what we're doing. In this location, I felt I had that facility.
This solitude has enabled his son to remain squarely focused on his opponent, a far cry from the scenario he faced leading up to the Hopkins fight. First, news surfaced that Trinidad had fathered a child outside his previously stable marriage. And then?
You have to remember that the week of the fight was the terrorist action at the World Trade Center.
The fight, originally scheduled for September 15, was rescheduled for September 29. And just minutes before fight time, the New York State Athletic Commission ordered Trinidad to rewrap his hands in compliance with commission rules.
I've always wrapped his hands the same way, and I think it affected his mindset for this fight. My father might be right, and he is concerned for what is best for me. However, I am a fighter who is focused on what I am doing.
The hand wrap incident still strikes a nerve with Trinidad Sr.
I will wrap the hands as always. There won't be any differences. That was a ridiculous act.
Despite Trinidad Sr.'s defiance, future opponents and other boxing commissions may one day put the Trinidads in a similar position. How they will respond is uncertain.
We would have to wait for that moment to come. I can't give you an answer.
Tonight, Felix Trinidad will begin to answer important questions about his future as he takes the first step toward erasing the memory of his only professional defeat.
It was not an easy thing to accept. Wow, I have a loss. But I am here trying to show who Tito Trinidad really is.
Here is the former WBC middleweight champion of the world. Aquí está el ex campeón del mundo peso mediano, introducing Hasan Sherifi. With a record of 40 wins, one loss, he has 33 wins coming by way of knockout. He is a five-time world champion in three-weight divisions, presentando al cinco veces campeón del mundo, demos la bienvenida al sensacional Felix.
Choque los guantes, suerte, good luck.
What we're watching for is whether Tito has made any changes, and secondly, how he will deal with being tagged a good shot if that happens.
Trinidad seems to just want to land some punches here in the first round. Hasn't really opened up on any of his shots.
You see, once you've been knocked out, every shot you get, you have to question yourself. Is this another one of those?
But nevertheless, enough to knock Shariki back. Another left hook. Trinidad beginning to loosen up his money punch. Counter with the straight right hand, well aware of which punch it was. Trinidad couldn't stop in New York. But here comes Tito, dabbing and dabbing again to set up another power shot. And there's a brilliant combination. And that left hook was an explosion.
Trinidad is back. Back on the block.
I can't say that I've seen him flinch from anything, really. Been hit a few times, which is good. But this is vintage Trinidad right here.
There was a vicious body shot with the left hand. Almost a minute still to go in the fourth, and there's a huge right hand. And another devastating left hook. Third knockdown of the fight. And Shariki shows tremendous courage.
And Shariki waves his hand as if to say, cheer for your hero. That was a great shot.
So the 34th knockout victory of Felix Tito Trinidad's career, and exactly the bounce back that his father and promoter Don King were looking for after the knockout loss to Bernard.
73 in Fajardo, Puerto Rico. He began as a pro in 1990. In his 20th pro bout, he stopped Maurice Blacker to capture the IBF welterweight crown. 15 successful defenses later, 12 by knockout, following including victories over Hector Camacho, Yuri Boricampos, Obakar, Pernell Whitaker, and Oscar De La Hoya. 2001, he became a three-division champion, defeating William Joppy. A dynamic puncher with explosive left hook, 2014 Hall of Fame inductee. In the modern category, Felix Tito Trinidad.
Bien, me siento bien contento de estar aquí con todos y cada uno de los presentes, especialmente a todos los campeones de Puerto Rico. Mi carrera, gracias a Dios, una carrera desde muy niño. Mi padre hizo recuerdo en esos tiempos, un gimnasio que de verdad que es un gimnasio muy, muy chico. Mi padre fue boxeador profesional, campeón nacional de Puerto Rico. Y de verdad que cuando ya se retira del boxeo, pues junto con un primo de él, quiso montar un gimnasio para llevar a cabo lo que había aprendido. De toda la familia, primo, Tito Tiniape se encaminó junto con mi padre al mundo del boxeo. Desde Cupey siempre salíamos en la tarde, después luego llegarle de la escuela, llegábamos, salíamos a gimnasio. Siempre mi padre, después que llegaba del trabajo, con mucho esfuerzo, salíamos para el gimnasio a hacer lo que en sí podíamos hacer, que era 100% el boxeo. Quiero decirle que no fue fácil, fue un trabajo de equipo. Ya para el 1990 hago mi debut como profesional, en el cual gano mi debut por nocaut técnico. Y de ahí en adelante mi carrera surgió de gran manera. Gracias a Dios pude ganar 5 títulos mundiales en toda mi carrera. Yo Yo sé que ustedes posiblemente saben que el boxeador, esta carrera del deporte de boxeo no es fácil, pero se puede, se puede. Yo la hice y con todo el corazón estoy más que orgulloso de que hoy día nos voy a reconocer, pero más aún de haber sido boxeador por toda casi una vida. Quiero dejarles saber que la familia mía es una familia que siempre me ha apoyado, siempre me ha estado conmigo dentro de toda mi carrera. A todos y cada uno del grupo Team Trinidad, lo hablo con mucho orgullo. La persona que, gracias a Dios, me trajo al mundo. Mi madre, Irma Doris, que está aquí de frente. Dejarle saber que sin esta persona que voy a mencionar ahora, lo más seguro, estoy seguro, que no estuviese hoy parado aquí. Aparte de ser mi padre, ha sido el mejor padre, ha sido el mejor manejador, ha sido el mejor trainer.
The best trainer.
Porque luchó día a día con todo para poder llevarme a lo más grande, a estar aquí hoy en el Día del Salón de la Fama. Este premio, esta sortija muy linda, son parte también tuya. De corazón. Te quiero, te amo. Y de verdad, de los años que papito Dios me dé, siempre, siempre estaré agradecido de ti. Siempre. Mencionarle a un joven puertorriqueño, como decimos nosotros, de pura cepa, que está subiendo, como decimos nosotros, como la espuma, que va muy bien encaminado a ser campeón mundial cuando sea el momento. Y ese es Félix Verdejo, que está aquí a mi izquierda. Te bendiga, Félix. Sigue hacia adelante, trabajando duro. Voy a ti. A todos ustedes, mis fanáticos, mi gente. Saludos a toda la prensa que está aquí presente, en especial a la de Puerto Rico.
Especially from Puerto Rico.
Pero amo el boxeo, amo mi gente. Puerto Rico, gracias.
Thank you.
Presenting the boxing, the bottom boxing Hall of Fame to Felix Tito Trinidad.
Y de verdad que a las 2:12 le dije
contender. Please yo sé lo que son los encantos Tito de mi borrilla. Qué hermosa, que sola quiero yo tanto.
No quitting blocker, por siempre la llamaré.
Preciosa. Yo sé de sus hembras trigueñas, sé del olor de sus rosas, beso a mi tierra riqueña, por siempre la llamaré preciosa. Por ser un encanto que se y tienes la noble hidalguía de la madre España y el fiero cantío del indio bravío lo tienes también. Preciosa te llaman los bardos que cantan tu historia. No importa el tirano, te tirate con negra maldad. Preciosa será sin bandera, sin lauros, ni gloria. Preciosa, preciosa, te llaman los hijos de la libertad. Te llaman los barros que cantan tu historia. No importa el tirano, te tira de la maldad. Preciosa será sin bandera, sin lauros, ni gloria. Oh, preciosa, preciosa, te llaman los hijos de
Puerto Rico.